The jury is now in its fourth hour of deliberations in the Joseph Banis murder trial. Banis is accused of killing 37-year-old James Carroll in December of 2009, then burying his body in the basement of the Old Louisville home he shared with his boyfriend, Jeffrey Mundt. Eric King has covered the trial from the opening gavel. He joins us now live outside the Judicial Center downtown with the very latest. Eric?
Yeah, can you imagine being a juror in this case for 8 trial days? You've had every salacious detail thrown at you, and then today in your closing arguments, they say, don't pay attention to that. Look straight at the facts and nothing but the facts. From the start, it was a who did it and why. Joseph Banis or Jeffrey Mundt.
This isn't my first rodeo. I've been in here before. I knew they were going to come in here and make you think that your job was to choose.
But in her closing argument, prosecutor Ryan Conroy told jurors that's in fact not the case. She says Banis and Mundt are both guilty, but today is Banis's day to be held accountable.
Your job has always been to judge the guilt of Joseph Banis. That has been your only job. And today is the day that you get the right person.
Banis's attorney says Conroy did not do her job and proved beyond a reasonable doubt it was Banis who killed James Carroll, but points out there was wrongdoing on Banis's part.
And he should have gone to the authorities and he should have immediately told them what happened, but he didn't. He didn't, okay? But that does not make him a murderer. It does not make him a robber. It makes him stupid. It makes him make me get up here and explain to you why he did something that damn stupid, but it doesn't make him a murderer.
So here we are, hour 4 of deliberations. The jury's been locked in a room for almost that entire time. They came back with a question at one point, and then they've gone back to finish their deliberations. They do have somewhat of a difficult road ahead of them. They've got 10 counts that they have to look at, and they have to decide guilt or innocence on each one of those counts. So we expect this deliberation to last quite some time. Live downtown, I'm Eric King, WLKY News.